स्टूडेंट्स, मैसेल्फ डॉक्टर भारती पाटिल. वी हैव स्टार्टेड अवर सिलेबस रिलेटेड टू नंबर सिस्टम्स एंड लॉजिक गेट्स. वी हैव कवर्ड द पॉइंट्स रिलेटेड टू नंबर सिस्टम्स एंड वी हैव आल्सो स्टार्टेड लुकिंग इनटू द कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू लॉजिक गेट्स. रिलेटेड टू लॉजिक गेट्स, वी हैव कवर्ड द बेसिक लॉजिक गेट्स इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स. एंड इन अवर फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ लॉजिक गेट्स, वी हैव सीन व्हाट आर द लॉजिक गेट्स. And we have covered the first logic gate, that is AND operation or AND gate. During our second lecture based on logic gates, we have covered the points related to OR gate and NOT gate. These are all basic logic gates. And now in today's lecture, we are going to see the universal logic gates. Basic logic gates we have studied are AND, OR, and NOT. So these are the logic gates we have studied. In today's lecture, we are going to see universal logic gates. And these universal logic gates consist of two gates, and these are named as NAND, NAND gate, and NOR gate. And these logic gates are derived from the AND, OR, and NOT gates. These are the logic gates which are derived from basic logic gates. And these are named as universal logic gates because all operations related to AND, OR, and NOT are performed or can be performed with the help of NAND, and NOR gates. So these gates are very much important because they are derived from the basic gates and they are performing all the operations related to the basic logic gates. Hence they are named as universal logic gates. Now in today's lecture, we are going to cover the points related to NAND gate. So NAND gate. So NAND gate is nothing but NOT AND gate. NOT AND gate. It is nothing but NOT AND gate. Means AND gate and it is not a AND gate. So it is named as NAND gate. We know that in case of AND gate, suppose if we are having two inputs A and B, then their output is represented by Y is equal to A dot B. Means A dot B means nothing but product of A and B. Suppose these are two inputs, A and B are inputs. So inputs are A and B, then Y is equal to A dot B, product of A dot B. And now you have to perform a NOT operation on AND. So NOT operation on AND, suppose NOT operation on AND means suppose AND gate is represented by such a symbol. This is the representation of AND gate. and y is equal to a dot b. That is product of two inputs. And now NOT AND gate means I have to perform a NOT operation. It means that I have to add a inverted gate. That is, it is called as NOT gate. Suppose I invert the output of given AND gate, then what will happen? I will obtain an output and it will nothing but the complement of product. And that output is nothing but the NAND gate's output. So it is going to represent as NAND gate's output. So what we have seen up till now? We have seen that NAND operation is the derived operation. It is called as universal logic gates because with the help of NAND gate, one can perform AND operation or NOT operation. Then or any operations that can be performed with the help of basic logic gates. So its importance is very much. And here I have shown the symbol for the AND gate. Symbol for AND gate where we have used A and B as inputs and output is given by A dot B. Now I have to represent the NAND. So I have added here NOT gate and it will invert the output of this AND gate and it will give me output as A dot B complement. And this is nothing but the output of NAND gate. Then how to represent the NAND gate? So representation of NAND gate is nothing but the symbol of NAND gate here we have added a NOT gate. So it is very easy. It is same as the AND gate. And as a representation of NOT gate, we have to add a circle on output side. We have to add a circle on output side which will tell us the inverted operation. So here is A, here is B, and we know that output is given as A dot B in case of AND. And now we have to get an inverted operation with the help of this NOT. So here this is the representation of NAND gate. Now we will draw a truth table for the NAND gate. So in order to understand truth table for NAND gate, so here we will have inputs and here we will have output. In case of inputs, we are using A and B as inputs and we are going to get Y as complement of product. So here 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 1. Now it means that we are going to vary A and B as 0 0, then 0 1, then 1 0 and then 1 1, and we are going to see what will be the outputs as a NAND gate is used. In order to understand this, one should have a clear idea about the AND gate in mind, because we should know what is AND gate and we have to invert its output and that is going to give us the NAND output. So here we know that suppose I am using A dot B, means I am performing A dot B, that is AND operation. AND operation is nothing but the, this is for only your understanding, because it, that truth table is not in front of you. In order to get a clear idea, one should have the idea about the AND gate. So here I have written, it is as a rough work, that is A dot B. And now we have to take a product. 0, 0 is going to give me a 0. 0, 1 is going to give me a 0. Then 1, 0 is going to give me a 0. But 1, 1, that is logic high. So it is product of 1 and 1 is going to, product of 0 and 0 is 0. 0 and 1 product is 0. 1 and 0 product is 0. But 1 and 1 state is going to give me a product as 1, logic 1. And this is related to AND operation. Now, here in NAND operation, we have to add a NOT gate. So it will invert the output. So we have to invert this A dot B's value. So here is 0. So here will become 1. 0 will become 1. 0 will become 1. And 1 will become a 0. This is my truth table related to NAND operation. So now I will rub this related to AND. So after looking at the truth table, what one can conclude? So conclusion from this truth table related to AND operation, NAND operation, is that the output of NAND gate, output of NAND gate will be at logic 1 if all of its inputs or one of the inputs will be at logic low or logic 0. What is the conclusion? Output of NAND gate will be at logic 1 or logic high state if all or any of its inputs are at logic 0. Check, output is 1 when both of the inputs are 0. Output is 1 with any of the input is 0. Output is 1 when any of the input is 0. So this is the conclusion related to NAND operation. So let's revise. In today's lecture, we have seen the NAND operation, and NAND operation or the NAND gate is called as universal logic gate because it can perform all the operations that can be performed by the basic logic gates, that is NAND, OR and NOT gate. Then we know that in case of AND gate, we are taking a product of inputs, that is A dot B. We are using dot to represent the NAND AND gate. And here we have to add a NOT operation. So when we add a NOT operation for a AND gate, here I have represented AND. There are two inputs and the output of AND operation is Y is equal to product of both inputs, and I have added a NOT gate. It will give me a complement of product, and this is nothing but the output of NAND gate. And here the symbol for NAND gate is represented. Now looking into the truth table of NAND gate, I should have a truth table for AND gate in my mind, and I have to invert its output in order to get output of NAND gate. And here I have obtained the output of NAND gate. And conclusion from the output of truth table of NAND gate is that output of NAND gate will be at logic 1 if all or any of its inputs are at logic 0. Thank you.